Let's now check on the situation in San Pedro Laguna from our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Jackie?
Good afternoon, Denise. Parts of San Pedro Laguna remain submerged as of this time. Ankle-deep floods are still affecting parts of Barangay Salandayan and Rosario. Water have entered many of the homes and families have transferred some of their things to the second floor or to an elevated area. Though many say they are used to floods, as San Pedro is a coastal city bordering Laguna Dibay, residents still said that they were surprised by the sudden rains early this morning, which actually forced them to wake up. Barangay San Antonio was among the areas hit by waist-deep floods earlier, but floods have already subsided as of this afternoon. San Pedro Mayor Art Mercado said they continue to monitor the situation as the light rain still persists. He said there are nearly 200 families currently in the evacuation center and relief goods will be given to affected families. Denise, I'm here right now at Landayan. It's one of the villages or barangays here in San Pedro, and floods or ankle-deep floods are still there are still ankle-deep floods in this area, and many people are just wading to the flood, walking to their homes, and some shops are still open as of this time. And that's the latest from San Pedro Laguna. Back to you, Denise.
Jackie, how's the electricity there? No worries when it comes to power supply lines?
That's right, Denise. Actually, I'm here along the sidewalk, and I can see the floods are ankle-deep. Many people are walking, but There is a power connection inside the homes of the residents here. So far, power is operating normally here in this part of San Pedro Laguna, Denise.
And is the local government preparing just in case the rains go or they become heavier the next day? I mean, we were talking to MMDA chairman and he's expecting that the rains might be a bit heavier tomorrow. So they've already had standby personnel waiting and are prepared for that. Is that the same in your area?
That's right, Denise. I also asked Mayor Art Mercado, because right now it's drizzling, light rains only as of this time. But I told him that weather could worsen in the coming hours or in the coming days. And he said that they are prepared in case the weather worsens. And there are personnel deployed in many parts of the city. And of course, they have already prepared for relief goods and the evacuation centers as well, in case more families will need to evacuate to higher grounds, Denise.
Lastly, Jackie, this might be too early to ask, but will classes, government work be suspended tomorrow in the area?
The mayor has not yet announced if classes or work will be suspended tomorrow, but he mentioned that they will announce it as soon as possible, as soon as they assess the situation in the coming hours, Denise.
Jackie Pascual with that report. Thank you so much, Jackie. Please take care. And we're also keeping a close watch on the situation at the La Mesa Dam. At noontime today, PAGASA said water level there has risen to 80 meters. It said excess floodwaters will overflow once dam elevation reaches 80.15 meters. PAGASA warns this would affect low-lying areas along the Tulyahan River, that's parts of Quezon City, as well as Valenzuela and Malabon. Now, residents in those areas, especially those near riverbanks, were told to be on alert should the water level along the Tulyahan further go up. Meanwhile, in Cavite, some residents in Bacoor are forced to evacuate due to massive floods. Rescue units were also deployed in villages where waist-deep floods submerged homes. Meanwhile, some passengers were stranded in the city as gutter to knee-deep floods were recorded in several streets. As of this morning, small cars and motorcycles could still pass through roads. A barge carrier ran aground in the coastal area of Rosario, Cavite, Monday due to bad weather. Jervis Manahan reports.
So we're now here in Barangay Wawa 2 in Rosario, Cavite, after seeing reports that the barge carrier ran aground in their coastal area due to bad weather. Fisher Folk Group of Malacaya reported that the anchor broke and that the barge was washed ashore earlier this morning. Fishermen had to relocate their boat because of the incident, and residents fear that the carrier might destroy their homes by the sea. Prior to this, we also went around Bacoor in Cavite, where flood is already waist to chest deep in some parts. In Barangay Talaba 3, residents were already evacuating as it started flooding since past 10 last night. Village officials say water rose quickly, prompting residents to move to the second floors of their homes. A portion of the main road near the public market is also submerged in water. A lot of people are panic buying food for their families as relief is yet to come. Right now, we are experiencing light to moderate rains here in Rosario, Cavite, and the PCC team is investigating as to what happened to the barge carrier that ran aground here at the coastal area in Cavite.
At least 6 fatalities reported in Antipolo due to landslides and drowning. Joining us now on the line for more on that, we have the head of the Antipolo City Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, Relly Bernardo. Mr. Bernardo, thank you so much for joining us today.
Yes, hello, ma'am. Good afternoon.
May I ask, what's the current situation in Antipolo? Are there still heavy rains, heavy winds?
Yes, as of now, we are experiencing light rains as of now, but earlier we received around heavy rains causing for some barangays to experience flooding and landslide. So as of now, we have 6 casualties as of the moment. So 3 due to landslide. And 3 others due to drowning incidents. So we have also 1 reported missing person due to drowning also. As of the moment, as of 1 p.m., already have 18 evacuation centers from several barangays, and this is a total of 349 families or 1,136 individuals.
Are evacuation efforts still currently ongoing right now in Antipolo?
Yes, ma'am. In some areas, although the flood has already subsided, we are still waiting for the updates from other barangays, since they requested that they would still focus muna po in the rescue operations earlier. So we might expect a bigger number after this afternoon.
Mr. Bernardo, we're really so sorry for the fatalities and the missing reports, but what are some of what are the barangays, or which barangays, which areas in Antipolo were reported to be most hard hit by Enteng?
Okay. We can say, in terms of the numbers, we can say that Barangay San Jose, which is the largest barangay in Antipolo, is the most affected, no? We have 126 families there affected, or a total of 420 individuals. Next is Barangay Mayamot with 85 Barangay Munting Dilaw with 85 families, or a total of 382 individuals.
Mr. Bernardo, I know that the floods are subsiding. We're so glad for that update. Are the evacuees, is it safe for them to go back to their homes, or is it still on standby until the day ends?
I think as of the moment, we are not still encouraging the people to go back to their houses yet, no, because they're still, the rain is still ongoing. So although based on the Pagasa's forecast, we might experience an improving weather, yet the Bagyo Enteng, you know, still inside within the Philippine area of responsibility, which might still pool or and cause rains due to the habagat.
Could you give us an update on current power outages in the area as well, sir?
As of the moment, ma'am, we received no power interruption or even water interruption. So I think this is just this is good. So the only lifeline that is affected right now is the Dang Pari Road, where the landslide occurred, actually, where it claimed 3 lives.
And And will classes and government work be suspended tomorrow for the city?
Yes, we are already, the mayor already gave instructions to suspend classes tomorrow. We'll just wait, check, we'll just check if we will include the government offices. But as now, we can say that the classes will be suspended tomorrow.
And the Baler City Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, Mr. Relly Bernardo, thank you so much again, sir, for joining us.
Thank you.
Preemptive evacuations conducted in the town of Marilao in Bulacan as floodwaters rise. Some roads are no longer passable to light vehicles. Michael Delizo filed this report.
So, 9 in the morning, the flood water level in the Arcega, Sampalucan, and Ilalim ng Tulay areas in Barangay Tabingilog has quickly risen and making it inadvisable for light vehicles to pass. M. Santiago Street in Barangay Lias is also not passable to light vehicles. Heavy rain continues to pour in the province. The water level in Marilao River is now close to overflowing with only 2 meters left as the water continues to rise. Houses around the area, particularly in Barangay Ibayo, are already submerged and residents have parked vehicles on a bridge to protect them from the flooding. The town market is also submerged and now closed. The MacArthur Highway, a major thoroughfare in the province, is heavily flooded as well. Bulacan Governor Daniel Fernando, upon the recommendation of the Disaster Office, has suspended classes at all levels and closed government offices except for health, social services, and emergency response units due to the effects of Typhoon Anteng.